Team Northeastern is about to take the course. We are very excited as this day continues. This is the day. Years in the making, the ANA Avatar XPRIZE with $8 million in prize money still at stake. Five for first place, $2 million for second place, and $1 million for third. Team Northeastern is up to 5 points already as they approach the switch with at about the 3 minute mark. So they're obviously ahead of the teams that have gone previously that had all these connection issues.
And let's see if I can reach. Yes. Whoops. Okay. There we go. All right. Back up.
Switch looks like it is in a proper correct position. And there's 4 points. So yes, it has been awarded by the judge backstage. That is a giant video monitor wall in front of her. We can't quite see it, but she is seeing everything through a video screen that's about as tall as she is. And the hands are direct representations of the hands on the machine.
I like the two-handed manipulation. You've got two hands. You might as well use them.
7 points, 5.5 minutes in. At the canister, trying to determine which one weighs the most, and I put that in the spot. Didn't like that one. I am done with you, says Operator Peggy.
Again, you've got to make this happen.
And she knows the time to beat. She's looking at the top slot. There's no doubt about it in my mind that she's dedicated.
Yes.
That's in place. 5:50, 7 points, 3 tasks remaining. Wasn't given out. Even semifinals were significantly different. So to see the adjustments in a short period of time and what they've been able to do is phenomenal.
I mean, they lose appendages and everything. It's pretty incredible.
Lose the pinky.
But I mean, to your point, you know, that pinky caused them problems both of their other runs. And they were just like, you know what? We don't need it.
Wow.
Yeah, so that was pretty fast. We're not quite as fast as we need to be, but she's pretty good.
So 8:31 at the drill. So it's going to be, it won't be able to top Nimro's time from yesterday, but this is an incredible run for Team Northeastern. The hydraulics team, so far all of the hydraulics are staying where they're supposed to, and that's key. And now she's got to align that running drill with the hex bolt. And we see the close-up as well. And that's no easy task. The laser guidance there is...
Oh no. Almost lost that drill. She recovered it though. That's good.
She's trying to use the left hand to at least hold it up while she reassesses the drill in the right hand. So this is a highly complex grasping process.
She's gonna lose that one though because of how the...
Oh my!
Two-handed manipulation.
Because if this drill hits the ground now, that becomes an obstacle to this.
I know, waste time
problems.
Moving out and moving back though, so...
Yeah, no, this is...
Balancing.
Oh, there it goes.
I think it would be nice to have some sort of bird's eye view of yourself, like in a video game.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Third person action.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. As the grip again. Yeah. Right. From us out here, it's clear what that is. From her vision, we can sort of see in that third POV.
And if you have a headset on. Oh, hold on. Let's see. Well, that looks pretty good.
And off the title.
Oh, it's on it. Started on it.
Oftentimes your wrists, like we would use our wrists to adjust that, and wrists aren't as...
Her angle may help there, because it's going to pop out right away.
There it is.
11:45 for Team Northeastern.
So this part is absolutely crazy hard. Look at her view. You want to feel a rock, and not move it too much where you won't be able to grab it. And I think that was a downfall on my end on my run, was that I moved the good rock that I had already felt.
It's the amount of restraint that must be necessary, because you don't want to, can't interfere, because then we have a bigger issue, right? And to look at this and know, like, you were on it, and that left one had just, you had just nudged it to the back corner.
I think you can kind of see him over the, he's got his hands on his face, like, oh my goodness, what's happening? Getting to the two rocks you need to feel to make sure you know which one's which is...
It looks like she has the sensors that she wants and is trying to pick this one up.
Well, it's rough. So let me know when my arm's back online.
So she's reaching out to the team. Again, this is something this the operators can do. Correct, Patrick? You can reach out
right
for assistance, specific assistance. They can't offer.
No left arm?
Presuming with just the right arm, left arm is dead.
Okay, left arm is dead. That happens. That's all right. Okay, I can feel it. I can feel it. Oh.
What is that? What is
still?
You can get this.
Yeah, it's still time. There's literally no reason to stop trying. Oh, right at the edge. Oh, a precipice.
I know.
Also,
you're
just
back there.
The. I know that little black fabric is to add challenge, but man, it adds so much challenge.
Okay,
here.
Can I reach down?
Because if that gets pinched between the rock and the.
You can pull it right out of the ground.
Pull it right out of the ground.
Absolutely.
Which is really cool.
We're at 21 minutes, so again, we arrived here.
Oh,
at
she's got it, she's
at
got
12.
It.
Got to hold it. No, watch out for that fabric. Oh, wait a second.
Is it out? Yeah, there it is.
Good job.
She's a master operator, I got
a master operator. That was just tenacity and resilience.
Way to go, Peggy.
There it is. It looks like unofficially 2108 and all, but officially all 10 tasks are completed. The time is unofficial, but the task judge has completed the mission. Team Northeastern joins Paula and Nimro and Ava Trina as the teams that have completed the run. Now we'll wait to see how Peggy's operational points count. That's a 3-point system. There are 3 questions.
Man, I've got Stephen Alt back here, and we were talking, this might be better than game day. We actually had some fun watching in the background behind Peggy. You have to tell us who this is in the background of a member of your team, because there's still such a human element. I mean, this is you guys on the edge of your seats, the concern, the fear, the gasping. I mean, who is this, and is this how you're all feeling?
Yes, this is how we're all feeling. This is David. He's done an amazing job developing the hands that you see Peggy using and the hands on the robot.
You know what's so fun on the highlights? You can hear the applause back because everyone is on the edge of their seats as Peggy holds up the Pink Rock Club. So a big congratulations to Stephen Alt as well as Team Northeastern. Let's see what their scores look like today, Julia and Peggy.
So coming in third place with 14.5 points, in a time of 21 minutes and 9 seconds, I'd like to welcome from Boston, Team Northeastern.
Try the non-linear thing. Can we run the arms, please?
Yeah. Right now it's at more than half a meter a second.